So the great Donald Sutherland passed away a few days ago, and I've been thinking about his enormous cinematic legacy. I mean, this guy's work goes back to the 1960s for 7 decades. He has been in film, in television, so many extraordinary performances. As you probably well know, he never got an Oscar nomination, which is ridiculous. And I will be covering that topic in the upcoming Donald Sutherland and the Elusive Oscar video. But before I get to that, I want to count down what I think are the 10 best Donald Sutherland performances in the movies, which ones have really stuck with me throughout the years. Let's start with number 10, The Hunger Games.
Hope. 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 It is the only thing stronger than fear.
Probably the best thing about Donald Sutherland's performance in the Hunger Games franchise is that it will keep his legacy alive for many generations to come. I mean, we're going to talk about some amazing films he appeared in, many of which are in the 1970s, early 1980s, but let's be honest, his most famous role for many, many people throughout the world is always going to be his role in the Hunger Games movies. He's so captivating and charismatic and frightening and unpredictable in all four of those films. The moment I can never forget is at the end of Mockingjay Part 2, where he just starts laughing and laughing, and he knows he's about to die, like it's coming, but his reaction to his circumstance is just always a moment that has stuck with me. Number 9, Little Murders.
Last year, I married a musician who wanted to get married in order to stop masturbating. Please don't be startled. I'm not putting him down. That marriage did not work.
Now, this is definitely the least known film I'm going to talk about in this video. You probably haven't heard of Little Murders. It's a very interesting dark comedy from 1971 starring Elliot Gould and directed by Alan Arkin, one of the very few films he directed. It's a very flawed film, I have to be honest, but there is this one scene with Donald Sutherland that will take your breath away. He is so funny. Officiating a wedding, he is weird and hilarious and so very memorable in this film. Little Murders is proof that Donald Sutherland can show up in a film for one scene and completely steal the show. Number 8, Pride and Prejudice.
I cannot believe that anyone can deserve you. But it seems I am overruled.
As I said, easily his most famous role of the 21st century is in The Hunger Games. Probably number 2 in terms of the last 20-ish years is Pride and Prejudice from 2005, which is probably the best adaptation of Jane Austen's famous novel for a theatrical film. Just an extraordinary ensemble cast, Keira Knightley got an Oscar nomination, and Donald Sutherland has some very touching moments as the father. He gives gravitas and emotion to this role that in the hands of another actor could have been maudlin or sentimental, could have been a less effective take on this character, but Sutherland here absolutely soars. Number 7, Without Limits.
Nobody did it more often. Nobody did it better.
Now get this, the only major award nomination Donald Sutherland receives for a theatrical film after 1981 comes in 1999 in the Best Supporting Actor category at the Golden Globe Awards for his performance in Without Limits, where he plays the coach to renowned runner Steve Prefontaine. This was a very small movie, it did well with critics, but not so much at the box office, so I just don't think there was enough excitement around the movie to get him to an Oscar nomination. But he is extraordinary in this film. He's got a few powerhouse moments, one where he's crying and being reflective. This is not a movie that many people are talking about these days, but if you're a Donald Sutherland fan, go check it out. Number 6, Invasion of the Body Snatchers.
She's a mathlete.
Don't tell him where she is.
There's no missing body.
No, that's right.
There is a missing body, and he's taken it away.
Something I always loved about Donald Sutherland is that he was always open to genre films. He did not snub his nose at action or science fiction or horror. He was a constantly working actor who made the best of every project he agreed to. I mean, Virus, hello, he made the best of Virus. His best science fiction movie easily is 1978's Invasion of the Body Snatchers, where he has a terrifying final scene. I feel like it's famous enough that if people haven't even watched the film, they know this part. They've seen it online. The way he opens his eyes and points, and you know something is not right. But he is great throughout the entire movie. It's a solid dramatic performance in what's probably the best version of that story put on film. Number 5, 6 Degrees of Separation.
My life, can I account for all of it?
I am a gambler.
We're a terrible match.
So when it came to award season, Stalker Channing got all the attention for the superb 1993 drama 6 Degrees of Separation. She got an Oscar nomination for Best Actress in a very crowded field that year. Her role, I would say, is a little bit flashier in that film than Sutherland's. There are many scenes where she is kind of going off the deep end and he is mostly reacting to her. But I think Sutherland is also excellent in this. He shows strength and purpose under pressure, and it's probably, I would say, his finest film performance in the 1990s. Number 4, Klutz.
Doesn't it get lonely down there in your little room? Or maybe I can bring you some friends. I've got some terrific friends.
No, thank you.
Alright, so now we get to the 4 big ones, what are probably his most beloved performances in all of these decades of filmmaking. These are the 4 essentials. If you have not seen my picks for number 4, 3, 2, and 1, these are the movies to start with to celebrate Donald Sutherland. Now, 1971's Klute, directed by Alan J. Pakula, is an interesting case of a movie where Sutherland has the title role. He is in this thing basically from beginning to end. But all of these decades later, it's not really the Sutherland performance that we take with us the most. It is the performance of Jane Fonda, who won the Oscar that year for Best Actress, for her superlative performance as the prostitute Bree Daniel. She is electric in this, in her scenes alone, with potential customers, at the therapist's office, and of course, in her scenes with Sutherland. Fonda and Sutherland had a romantic relationship after making this movie. Maybe on the movie, I don't really know. And you just feel their chemistry in every moment. Even though it is the Fonda performance that got all the recognition, I don't think the movie works without that effective, grounded Sutherland performance. Number 3, Don't Look Now.
I was outside, went inside the pension last night where they lived. And today, when I went to, before I came here, I went to look for it.
Oh my God, Don't Look Now. This movie is amazing, and it features 2 spectacular performances by Donald Sutherland and Julie Christie. They play a married couple who are grieving the sudden loss of their young daughter, and while they're in Venice, they come across these elderly sisters who say that they have visions of their daughter trying to reach out to them, and it's just a very unique, haunting story from the mastermind Nicholas Roeg. Gorgeous cinematography, unusual storytelling techniques. It's of course very famous for that explicit sex scene between Sutherland and Christie, but the movie is so much more than that. It really takes your breath away, especially by the end. Sutherland got a Best Actor BAFTA Award nomination for this film, very much deserved. Number 2, MASH.
There doesn't appear to be any reason. I've seen you somewhere before. I don't know your name, stranger, but your face is familiar. You always had that mustache.
Sutherland got his first Golden Globe Award nomination for MASH in the Best Actor in a Motion Picture Comedy or Musical category, along with his co-star Elliot Gould. This movie was a huge hit for critics and audiences back in 1970. I've seen this one multiple times. I watched it on the big screen at one point, and it continues to feel fresh after all of these years. It really put director Robert Altman on the map, and even though Sutherland had been making movies for a few years, he has some credits in the 60s. This was his breakthrough. He is so funny in this, so unpredictable, unusual. He tries things. Some of them don't work, but most of them do. And I love his chemistry with Elliot Gould. They work really well together. He could have gotten an Oscar nomination for this one, I guess, but it's hard to get into Best Actor for a comedy. Regardless, he is fantastic in MASH, one of his essential roles and films. Alright, before I get to my number one choice, here are a few runners-up. I had to mention The Dirty Dozen from 1967. This is his first significant role in a movie, and it's the first time he really gets to show his personality on screen. He is excellent in two films from 1991, Backdraft and JFK. I feel like his work in either of these movies would have been deserving of a Best Supporting Actor Oscar nomination. The problem was both films had such huge ensemble casts, it was hard to stand out, and unfortunately he didn't get quite a lot of screen time in either film. In terms of recent years, I adored his performances in Ad Astra from 2019, and what I think is pretty underrated, it went straight to Netflix, Mr. Harrigan's Phone from 2022. He's also terrific in a couple other ensemble dramas from the mid-1990s, Outbreak from 1995, and A Time to Kill from 1996. Sutherland didn't often appear in the same movie with his son Kiefer, but they're both in A Time to Kill, and they're both excellent. And before I get to my number one choice, I have to give a shout out to the first Donald Sutherland movie I ever remember watching. I loved it back in the day. It's kind of cheesy. I don't know how you feel about Buffy the Vampire Slayer from 1992, where he plays the Watcher, but I think he gives a very memorable performance in a movie that's always been close to my heart. And now finally, this is not going to be a surprise, my number one choice for the best Donald Sutherland performance in a movie is Ordinary People.
So I was crying. Because I don't know if I love you anymore.
This is, by far, one of the most egregious acting Oscar snubs ever. You look to the lineup of Best Actor 1980, and it's not like you say, well, all five of these performances are stellar, there just wasn't a way for Sutherland to break in. He could have broken in here. He could have taken the slot that went to Robert Duvall for The Great Santini, or Jack Lemmon for Tribute, or Peter O'Toole for The Stuntman. I don't think any one of those three performances necessarily had to get in, and what makes this snub so very weird to this day is that Ordinary People was beloved by the Academy. I mean, it won the Oscars for Best Picture, and Best Director for Robert Redford, and Best Supporting Actor for Timothy Hutton, and Best Adapted Screenplay. Mary Tyler Moore is nominated in Best Actress. They even nominated Judd Hirsch, also in Supporting Actor. It's like, what the hell did they have against Donald Sutherland? He had been doing phenomenal work all throughout the 1970s. Here was the moment the Academy had a very good reason to give him a Best Actor Oscar nomination, and they fumbled the ball big time. I mean, seriously, this Oscar nomination should have happened. Ordinary People, like Don't Look Now, is also about the loss of a child and how it affects the family. Everybody is on their A game in this. It's so perfectly cast, beautifully written and directed and shot and paced, and that Donald Sutherland performance is devastating. This is subtle, authentic, grounded, masterful work from the great Donald Sutherland. In his 200 credits in film and TV, he obviously gave so many wonderful performances, but I do think the best one, like the very best performance Donald Sutherland ever gave in a movie, is in Ordinary People. Thanks so much for watching and subscribing, and let me know in the comments below, what are your favorite Donald Sutherland performances? Is there anything I didn't mention in this video? Stay tuned for Donald Sutherland and the Elusive Oscar coming your way shortly, and we'll see you next time at the Awards Contender.